I guess I'll come back here and finish burning this infestation zone later.
I can do.
Here we go. Never gets old.
I'm just gonna grab some shot eye. Should do it.
get back to work.
Brian, this has got to be it.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not a doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sarge, Lieutenant O'Brien, how long are we going to be here?
I thought I saw something on our approach. I want to check it out.
Yeah?
It's probably nothing. Fresh carry, maybe.
Okay, Doc. Lieutenant. Don't become carry on yourself.
Only animals can become carry on humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
Lieutenant O'Brien, field note 2006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Demonocentrotus or Ventera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I could not discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, a recent carrion is indicated. Should be just over here. Damn it, where is it?
Thank you.
striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection of the spring HB. Take sample to confirm.
This way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself. I would have that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive, O'Brien?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night,
Nero Protocol 2-7 states
that everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb
Nero
for goddamn
Protocol
limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell is you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little spacesuit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
And I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't. Hey, don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did the woman, your wife? I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Brian,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.